I'm Anil Kumar, and here is a key video for understanding logarithmic functions graph. The question here is, use transformation to sketch the graph of minus 2 log to the base 10 of x minus 3 plus 1. Now, in this particular function, what we are given here is the base function, which is log to the base 10 of x. And we can now write down all the transformations. So the transformations are, starting from here, reflection on x-axis. And then we have vertical stretch by factor of 2. Then this 3 is horizontal translation. 3 units right, and we have vertical translation. Of 1 unit. What I'm going to do in this video is that first we will sketch log to the base 10x, the base function, and then perform these transformations. We also have another approach, and that is from the key points in the base function, we can actually apply the transformation, get the image point, and plot those points. So I'm going to take both the approaches in this video. So this video is going to be crossing our limit of 10 minutes. So if you have that patience, go through it. Okay, now here is how we are going to plot the base function log to the base 10x. So whenever you take points for the base function, first foremost point is always the vertical asymptote. So we say x equals to 0 is vertical asymptote. So that is the base to start with. So vertical asymptote. Okay. Now, looking at the base, which is 10, x values are always 10 to the power of something, correct? You could also write this function as, when we say, let me write here, y equals to log to the base 10 of x, we also mean that 10 to the power of y is equals to x, correct? So that gives you a hint. X values are 10 to the power of something. So always take points which are 10 to the power of something, correct? Okay, I think it's very close to my graph. So what I will do is, I will take a lighter color. Okay, so we will override these values later. 10 to the power of 0, which really means what? Anything to the power of 0 is 1, y value is 0. That is how you have to calculate the points. It doesn't matter which base. We are at present working with 10, so I have taken 10 here. 10 to the power of 1, y value is 1, and 10 to the power of 1 is 10, you know that, right? And 10 to the power of 2 is 100, y value should be 2. So that's the kind of key to take x values. 10 to the power of minus 1 means minus 1 here, sorry, 1 over 10, and minus 1 for y, right? 10 to the power of minus 2 means 1 over 100, the y value is minus 2. So that exponent is the y value. So if x is your x values given like this, the y values are these values. So we can plot these points. So the first point is the vertical asymptote. So that is the vertical asymptote for us. This is log to the base 10, correct? So we just plot this point here. Okay. And now the points for us are, let's take a lighter color. So this is a very light color. Starting from, let us say, 0, right? 10, x is, so the coordinates are 1, 0. So, okay, so let's make a scale also. So what should we take on this side? Well, let's say 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So let me take this as 10. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. This becomes 20. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 30. Well, that reminds me of one very interesting value, which you could always use. Since 100 is far away, we cannot take advantage of this value. There is one value for log to the base 10, and x value of 32 returns 1.5, a value between 1 and 2. We'll take that value, okay? So that will really help us to sketch a good graph from these given values. Right, so when x is 1, y is 0. So we have taken this as 2, that means this is your 1 point, right? When x is 10, y is 1. So let's take 2 divisions as 1, okay? So this is 1 for us, this is 2 for us, this is 3, kind of. Okay, this is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, fine. So we have 1. And as I said, at 32, it is 1.5, so 1.5. Now, when I say 1 over 10, it's very close, right? But minus 1. So what I'm doing is I'm just using this value here, which is very close. Assume it is 1/10. Joining these points, we get our function. Let me join them with a lighter color. So we get 10 to the power of, log to the base 10. So this is my vertical asymptote. You get the idea, right? So this is our base function, which is this function for us, right? Now we will follow steps to get the next function, which is transformation. So what we will do is we'll combine these two transformations first. That is reflection on x-axis and vertical stretch by a factor of 2. That is to say, x values will remain same, y values will get multiplied by minus 2. So if I multiply minus 1 by minus 2, I get plus 2. So I get a point here. If I multiply 0 by minus 2, it remains there. 1 by minus 2 brings me to minus 2. And 1.5 times minus 2 is minus 3. So I come here, which is minus 3. So that is my first step of transform function. So what I get here is kind of line which is very closely coming like this, very close. That y-intercept still the same, right? And then we add these points in our graph. There you go, kind of like this. Let me push this page a bit to the front. Okay, I hope now you can see it. So this graph is for minus 2 log to the base 10 of x. Do you see that? So we incorporate these two points. And now let us incorporate the other two translations, which are horizontal translation of 3 units and a vertical translation of 1 unit, right? So 3 units will be, this is 1 unit and this is 2. So horizontal 3 and 1 up. So this point moves to 1 up, means 2 divisions here. Again, 3 units and 1 up. So there you go. It is with this graph, So we are working on blue line, Now, 3 units here will be 3 and 1 up, so that is the point. Okay, 3, this should have been at half, not there. This is the point, correct. So 3 units, this is 1 unit, and then 2 units is like this. It's kind of, so 2 and 1, I should say, and then 1 up, so that is, again, let me see this. So we get 1 and 2, that is fine, Correct. Now here, this one, I took it at 30. This point originally should have been at 32. Okay, so we made a mistake here. That was at 32, 1.5. So this point was at 32, right? Right there. Okay, anyway, you understand. Now let me move this 3 units to the right and 1 up. So it comes at this position. So these are our new points. Okay, let me circle them once again. So what we are doing here is we are moving them 3 and 1 up. So we get this point. Okay. 3 and 1 up. That point is correct for us. So it is 3 and 1 up. This is also correct for us. And from here, we have 3 and 1 up. Perfect. So these are the points which we are considering. And let me sketch them. But before that, let me sketch the vertical asymptote. Vertical asymptote also moves by 3 units to the right and 1 up. That means 3 units to the right. So this happens to be my vertical asymptote. Okay. So 3 units means 1.5. So let me draw it here. Very close to my points, correct? It is going like this. or let me just draw a solid line first. So this is my vertical asymptote, and I'm writing my equation here. My equation here is x is equals to 3, right? So that is very clear. So that is the vertical asymptote for us. Now we will sketch the graph. Graph is very close to this vertical asymptote, right? Very close, as you can see. And then we have to take care of these points. So we'll just go like this and look at the point so that we could draw the graph. There you go. So that's the graph of our function, which is minus 2 log to the base 10 of x minus 3 plus 1. You get the idea. So that is how we have to sketch the function with the help of a graph. Now, what we could also do is actually we could also transform these points and then get the points direct and do it. So let's do that step also. So we'll do calculations one by one. So the x values should be, okay, let me use a dark color here. So the x values will get transformed. They get added by 3, right? So we have x plus 3. As far as the y values is concerned, minus 2 times original y value plus 1, correct? Now, 1 over 100 is my x value. So it first the vertical asymptote. So vertical asymptote will be at x equals to 0 plus 3. That is correct. So that is your vertical asymptote. Now, 1 over 100 plus 3, which is like 100, and the y value will be at this instance multiplied by minus 2, which will give me 4. 4 plus 1 as 5. So the y value will be 5 for this one. For this one, it is 1 over 10 plus 3, the x value. And the y value will be minus 1 times minus 2, which is 2. 2 plus 1 as 3. Next, we have 1. 1 plus 3 is 4. The y value will be 1. Then we have 10 here. 10 plus 3 is 13. And 1 times minus 2 is minus 1. Minus 1, okay, I'm sorry. 1 times minus 2 is minus 2. Minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1. Okay. And for 1.5, twice with negative sign is minus 3, that will give me 4, and 32 plus 3 is 35, right? So these are the points which we can check. So basically what we have here is good points to check are 4 and 1, right? So we are getting, so 4 is here, so let's check. So this is, each division is 2 for us. Each division is 2 for us. So 4 and 1, so that is correct. You see that this point is 4 and 1 for us. Then we have 13 and minus 1. So this point is 13 for x value and minus 1 for y value, correct? Then we have 35 and 4. As you can see, each division is 2 is, so this should be, we did a mistake calculating. So minus 3, 1.5 times minus 2 is minus 3, minus 3 plus 1 is plus 2. So it should be at 2, right? So it is at 2, that is correct. So this one is at 35 and 2. So this point is 35 and 2. Correct? Perfect. So we get all our points. So you could also actually sketch your graph by finding the image points. So these points which we have here are image points of the original points. So these are original, right? So at times what you can do, it depends on the type of question. If they want you to show the transformations, then you should do as we did here. But otherwise, you can calculate the points, plot them directly, and sketch your graph, correct? So that is how we could do it. So the final graph here is in this color. Let me put this color around the sketch. I know this is very complicated now, but if you follow the video right from the beginning, I hope you will understand and appreciate the steps which we took to sketch our graph. Follow these steps, and I hope they'll always get you the right answer. Thank you. and all the best.